Greetings, everyone, from Mr. Kit Kat and me. Woo! Sweet. Oh, goodness. Hey? Not happy there. Anyway. Ah, there we go. There we go. Right. We continue with this piece. Let me get my bearings by doing some scribbling. For starters, seems to have been a bit of a challenge with regards to the fibre line. So it's been down since yesterday, and I see it hasn't come back again this morning. So I might not be able to upload this video. Well, you won't be seeing this until I've uploaded it anyway, but so that it doesn't really matter. But yeah, this is like first world early morning challenges. It doesn't concern you anyway. I do wonder what it is that is going on. Of black conte here. Also just to deepen the shadow area. So I guess the problems are to do with killing Caesar. It being the Ides of March. Or Idus Martii, as the as they would have said in Rome. Anyway, it's all just part of the whole thing. So. Just want to start introducing a little bit of subtle colour today. A little bit of brown here, sort of chocolate brown. And some lighter sort of terracotta brown. I want to do that later on though. Right now, let's just put a little bit of green in for the time being. Just a few smudges, I just want to a little bit of that. Just want to start working on filling in more of this, the leafy upper reaches over here. If fact, I wanted to do that with, let's try it first of all with black. Yeah, that's the one. My compressed charcoal. Let's do this rather with my Conte, because I need a slightly finer line. Just because of the nature of these leaves as well. Not that I'm depicting leaf by leaf, but I also just want to get its mood interpreted. Yes, so what I need to do with darkening up in these upper leafy reaches of the pieces is to also balance out this part of the darkness as well with these two. So I am going to lighten that subtly as well with my eraser, but I just want to create that nice lighting, balance of lighting. And that will take time to build up a little bit. Right now I have the basis for it, but I really need to intensify it quite a lot. Probably about time I got myself another black contact round. I didn't realize that I'd almost run out. So yes, that'll be the next mission. woke up having been quite deep into a very involved dream, very complex dream, so I'm still a little bit brain dead at this point. Goodness me. That's what happens. Almost a little bit shell-shocked. It wasn't a nightmare exactly, but it was very complicated. I shan't go into the details. Okay, let's just work with my eraser for a while, and then I'll come over it again with my Conte and perhaps compressed charcoal. So I want to give the impression, rather than the actuality, of these blue gum eucalyptus leaves. And you get the idea of them, of the wind rushing through the leaves. Branches being much thinner and more flexible and pliant, swaying gently in the breeze. And the trunks basically solid as rocks. More work that needs to be done over that side. Let's get that out of the way. Let's put that back there. to be introducing later on some subtle shades of green and whatever in the top upper reaches here, yellows and so on, just so that that light, the appearance of the light filtering through subtly. Because there is this a couple of areas where the light will highlight these trees, and I want to focus on that honing in of the vision here of the species. So I want the surroundings to be far more intense in their mood, in their enveloping quality, and then there's this nature character of the gum trees that just is catching the light. The late afternoon sunlight. I'm using my compressed charcoal at this point. Literally just doodling, scribbling away. So the overall effect of the lighting will only become apparent later on, as I just build on the layering of this piece and the different the hues of colour and the form of it. So it's a gradual building of the impact. Mm. Let's bring in some yellow, a little bit of yellow here and there. I just want to get the feeling for this. No, not that. I think this more lemon yellow is what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for, but I just need to intensify it with the contrast, etc. As I work, I'm just trying to get the feeling of it going at this point. Getting there slowly. Once again, accentuating the not only the form of the trees in terms of their verticalness, but also the perspective of these leaning, appearing to lean in, and yet just enhancing that kind of the loftiness. Also need to create the subtle balance that comes about where I've got these two trees which appear to be very broad and very dominant, almost dominating the image. I want to enhance their lightness, in other words catching the light, and then further over towards the right here bring in the darkness more, as the eye draws towards the sunlight, the sunlight source, so that everything then becomes in silhouette, very dark. So we've got that visual balance of this piece created. Where is it? that back to using some charcoal again. And to pull it in. No, let's not use that. Rather, just keep on my compressed charcoal. Of course, in the background there's lots and lots of little saplings as well, and little offshoots, and creating quite a lot of clutter in these, in the lower areas. Where is that? No, not that one. Maybe it's this one. Hello again, Kit Kat. I imagine that it's... Yes, it's still... It's still drizzling a bit outside, so he's a little bit wet, eh? And he spent most of the night indoors, so it's obviously been raining throughout the night. little boy. Hey, what's up? I'm being stared at. Maybe he's just enthralled in what I'm doing. Hey, good cat. Yes, boy. perhaps still yet further deepening the contrast or enhancing the contrast, even in the darkest of areas over here. Earthy nature of this, of the ground in the foreground. Right, let's introduce a little bit of this deep green, sort of foresty green. Very subtly, mind you. As those of you who were attending my demonstration on the weekend might have noticed, I'm not very much one for knowing all the different particular names of all the colours and what they are. They just, for the most part, they're just colour. In fact, if anything, I see colours in terms of CMYK values, cyan, magenta, yellow, black, print combinations rather than and perhaps Pantone combinations even rather than their more artsy given names. I'm still so accustomed to quoting colours in terms of their percentages of cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. Otherwise, it's sea green, bottle green, forest green, spring green, sky blue, whatever takes my fancy. I must say at this point that there's a strong chance that I might complete this piece during today's session, because I'm realizing we've still got 15 minutes, nearly 20 minutes to go, and I'm well on the way. So, which means that tomorrow, or during our next session, I shall have to start a new piece. Ooh, I wonder what I shall do. Well, let's see if that eventuality does come to pass. As I introduce a little bit of smattering of lilac here. Throughout this piece, in fact, just a hint of sky peeping through here and there. Let me just finish that corner off. It also creates quite a nice contrast to the or discord rather with the in terms of color with these deep peachy blends. Lower down, at least on the trees themselves. Quite interesting. And a little pale blue as well. I do think during the demonstration on Saturday, I do think that I perhaps overfaced myself somewhat, especially with having to also introduce acrylics as well, so that whereas this piece doesn't have that, also I'm working with the same size and time frame, and there's been nowhere near as much pressure. Okay, anyway, it's lesson learned, and it was the first artistic demonstration I've done, so yeah, I think it generally went very well. I'm very pleased with the result, and enjoyed it, most importantly, like I was saying to you all yesterday. Thoroughly enjoyed the journey. It was lovely, really lovely. So a little bit of this spring green. Just to emulate the highlights of the light catching the leaves in certain areas, so it's not all quite so dark and dingy. It's just this lovely little splash of colour here and there. Some white, of course, as we move more now towards the light source, it becomes brighter and brighter, and the contrast becomes greater. So if you can imagine, we're looking up the hill and just over the top of the rise of the hill, and perhaps a bit off to the left is where the setting sun is. Well, it's not quite that very low light, but it is still quite intense. Which creates that almost a overexposure of light. Back a little bit and see. We are getting there. We're getting there. So although we have a focal point or focal area, which is around about here, the direction that the eye is drawn is uphill towards there, which is quite an interesting turn of events, artistically speaking. So the eye, first of all, is captivated by this area and is drawn in, and then sort of dwells in this on the ground over here, and then starts to shift. What's out there? What's beyond? As the lighting changes subtly, and that's quite interesting. So always drawn towards the light, like a moth. So when in composition, when composing the artwork, you know, you obviously work with the balance of contrast and what have you, and light and shade and all of that sort of thing, in terms of the structure of the piece, But then you get, if you let go of the control, as I'm always harping on about, when you let go of the control, then the piece creates itself and it creates its own story. And it's exactly what's emerged here with regards to its particular lighting being the source over there that draws the eye and so on and so forth. That wasn't me. That was the artwork itself. I am merely, as the artist, I'm merely the facilitator of that story, allowing that story to unfold. And if you are too much in control as the artist, then you don't allow stories to emerge as they should. And that's what I particularly enjoy about creating this way. Five or 6 minutes left. Do you want to introduce a little bit of sort of merry gold yellow up here as well? Just a touch, mind you. believe that we're done. There we go. I think we're done. So, let's sign off. Let me sign off. Let's sign off in this brown, actually. We'll change. Yeah. 22. Here we go. Done. Well, that was an unexpected turn of events, wasn't it? to actually complete in two sessions. Well, you never know what's going to transpire. Anyway, I've enjoyed that little journey. I hope you have too. I hope you've enjoyed the process. And once again, thank you to all of you new subscribers. Don't forget to hit the bell icon as well, just to get a notification when I upload again. So yes, thank you for being part of my little journey to along the way here. So we'll catch you again next time with something new, I imagine. So anyway, be good, be gentle, be kind, be caring, be loving. Oodles and oodles of toodles, and do tune in to the tube again on the morrow for something new. Yes, I shall definitely choose something fresh. Perhaps a seascape again, hey? What about it? So, yes, anyway, take care, have a fantastic day ahead, and see you again next time. Bye then. Don't forget to doodle.